wants to be seen. So what I'm doing right now is completely out of my comfort zone. It's completely out of my comfort zone. I was praying the other day, and the Lord brought me back to when Moses was talking to God, and he said, God, I want to see your glory. All of us want to see his glory, right? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All of us want to seek his face. But in the Bible, it also says, just a couple verses down, if you see my glory, you'll surely die. So every time we ask to see the glory of the Lord, we seek his face. We're asking for a death sentence to ourselves. And are we willing to take it? Are we willing to take it to see just a little bit of his glory? Are we willing to take it just to see a bit of his face? And then I went down the Bible, and then I seen where they tested Daniel in the lion's den, and they said, basically, either you won't pray for one day, basically, or you're going to die. And he said, I'm sorry. I can't help. I've got to see him. So he accepted his death penalty willingly just to see the glory of the Lord. And then God delivered him from it. And he still got to see the glory of the Lord because the lion walked around. The ultimate death penalty. For the Lord, I can just see him. He's been on this earth for a long time. And it's about that time when he knows that his death is surely to come. And I can't help but think when he's up there on that cross, I accept this death penalty. Because I haven't seen you in a long time. I haven't seen your face in a long time, Father. I'm accepting this death penalty. And every drop of blood that ran down was an invitation to do the same. But are you willing to take it? Are you willing to take it?
Oh,
attention. I've been wanting to sing it all weekend. I thought they were going to sing it tonight. They didn't. I said, sing it anyway. I felt like singing it. I'm telling you. When she gets to this part, I'm standing right here. In the mess of a tear. Some of you need to say, I know, but I'm standing right here. In the midst of this junk, in the midst of this mess, in the midst of my life, I'm standing right here in the midst of my tears. When she gets to that part, I want everybody in this house, especially the young people, you older ones alike, there's some of you struggling so much, you haven't got the breakthrough you need yet. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost is going to have his way. I'll preach it, the Lord lets me. You don't worry about that, but right now you need to obey the Holy Ghost and say right here, in the midst of this junk, I claim you to be the Lamb of God in my life. I don't care. I don't have nothing else to claim. I have nothing else to plead except to the Lamb of God. There's some breakthroughs going to happen tonight. The enemy's been fighting all night. I didn't go to sleep till way after 5 o'clock, almost 5:30, back up at 7 o'clock, couldn't sleep at all. I've been fighting all day. I went and laid down at 4 o'clock or 3:30, going to try to get some kind of rest and not slept a wink. And I'm telling you, I feel like God's going to do some miraculous things in this house tonight. Some great supernatural breakthroughs for them that want it. But right now, in the name of Jesus, when she gets to that part, I'm standing right here. I want you to take you. I want you to say, I declare it right now. I'm standing right here in the midst of my tears. And I claim you to be.